going to teach you social science. Today we are starting our new session. Here we will begin with our first chapter of SEM 1, that is two big states. Here we are learning about two states, that are Kannauj and Vatapi, and its brave kings, that is Harsh and Pulkeshi too. As per our earlier studies of 6th standard, we have learned that the emperor of our Indian history had always worked for the welfare of our country and the people of the country. Firstly, here we will learn about Harshvardhana. And Harshvardhana had all worked for the welfare of the country. Harshvardhana was born in 606 AD. Harshvardhana worked for the period of 606 to 647 AD. With the demise of the father Prabhakar Vardhana, the elder brother Rajyavardhana came to the throne. God King Shashank killed him by fraudulent means. His sister Rajeshri was imprisoned by Devgupta, the king of Malwa. In this critical circumstances, Harshvardhana shouldered the responsibility of Thaneshwar, that is present Punjab, Haryana, as advised by the leaders of the state. Immediately after coming to the throne, he decided to emancipate his imprisoned sister Rajeshri. With the help of friend like Buddha hermit Dwarka Mitra, he liberated Rajeshri. Since the state of Kannauj, that is Uttar Pradesh, was without any king, he took his sister's state also under his control. Later on, he defeated the Malwa king Devgupta as a part of the preparation of attack on Shashank, that is Gowda king. He tactfully joined hands with Bhaskar Varman of Kamrup, that is current Assam. He severely defeated Gowda king Shashank and won major part of his state. He also won Malwa and Saurashtra, but he did not get success as he expected in the battle with Pulkeshi II, the king of Chalukya dynasty in South India. But after his consecutive 7 years of victorious advance, he conquered the kings of North India and made small state of Thaneshwar a big empire. Here you can see that I have made the diagram in which the father Prabhakar Vardhana had two sons and one daughter. The first son, Rajyavardhana, who was killed by God King Shashank. The second son, Harshvardhana, who was appointed as king after elder brother's death. And Rajeshri, the sister, was imprisoned by Devgupta, the king of Malwa. You can remember the things with the help of this small diagram. Harshvardhana used to keep personal watch on the administration of the state. He used to travel extensively in different parts of his empire to supervise the administration. He had divided his routine in 3 parts. The first part was for administration, the second part was for the welfare of public, and third part was of religious duties. He forgot his meals in people welfare, and he was very much just and regular conduct his duty. King Harshvardhana had appointed many ministers for the smooth administration. Here he has appointed commander of the army. The second is Pratihara, that is Dwarpal. The next is Sadvigrahika, the foreign minister. The next is Rajdut, Pararajya Mantri. Mahadandanayaka, that is chief justice. Akshar Patalika, the register, etc., the other ministers to look after the welfare of the people and the smooth outflow of the administration. King Harshvardhana also built many rest houses, inns, stepwells, wells, lakes, mathas and viharas. He prohibited killing of animals. Every year he called for the Buddha religious meet, and every 5 years he organized religious congregation at Prayaga. Here congregation means a meeting held for religious purpose. He donated lavishly. At the time of religious congregation, he used to donate till his entire treasure emptied and the ornaments from body were given away. A great poet and writer, Banabhat was a gem of Harsha's court. Students, you must be knowing about the 9 gems of the Akbar's court. In the same way, Harshvardhana had gems in his court and one of them was Banabhat. His famous works were Harshcharitra and Kadambari, unparalleled in Sanskrit literature. King Harshvardhana was also a writer and he had written 3 plays that were Nagananda, Ratnavali and Priyadarshika. Here I would like to tell you that Harshcharitra had many important things of Harshvardhana's times. Here I would like to conclude with the things that you people have to read the chapter very nicely and very calmly. I will be giving you some hard words and their meanings at the end of the lesson. So children, please read the lesson properly and write down the doubts whichever are there. Thank you.